All right, well, stick around. Don't go anywhere. Hang out with us while we see our first semifinal battle between Travis Pastrana and Kevin Eriksson. So, again, Kevin Eriksson, welcome back to him. He suffered that injury where he missed the two rounds that were in Europe. And now here he is back behind the saddle of his trusty number 23, the OMSE vehicle. Again, two times RX2 champion, 2018, 2019, and six-time USA Rally champion, Travis Pastrana, in the 199, the Vermont sports car. Who's one to watch this weekend for us?
Travis has been very fast in all the practices. I've been right there with him. And, you know, I'm very excited to see what these guys are going to do. Because Kevin's first time back from his accident. And
yeah.
his driving style fits this track perfectly. And
yeah.
I'm excited to see both of these guys go for the big send right now.
Yeah, it's I'm super stoked you're okay. That's just priority. That was scary, man. All right, here we go. Travis Pastrana, Kevin Eriksson. Who's going to get the jump? Obviously, Pastrana has that inside line. Can he hold on to it? And here we go. Green means go. Nice start. Both even start. You see a little steam being made off of that pavement. And Pastrana gets the jump on Kevin. Nice, clean race line there from Pastrana. Coley.
Pastrana knows not to let the door open. He opened it once last year, if you remember, in Utah, and the Hansen took advantage of that. He will nail this onto the inside line. Doesn't go for the big flamboyant line. Now he's got to try and find some traction on the exit. Kevin Eriksson going to go the alternate line. Did he have any choice? Eriksson might now have that inside line. Can he get in front of Travis? I thought Travis had managed to keep it sharp, but Eriksson has snuck through. Travis now goes high on the handbrake. Here he goes for Vermont sports car. Can he get the lead back? 2.5 laps to go.
Well, this is what we're talking about. He was forced to that upper line. That's less than ideal. Kevin got both of the quicker inside lines. So here we go. Look, you can see him getting up into that bank. Now Travis getting out to that cushion. That's going to slow him down.
That's the same line we saw earlier on for Connor Martell. Those Vermont sports car cars look super hooked up in these conditions, Jared. They're able to really flip the car about. Fraz, what's he got to do here? Where's he going to get through? Where's your best bet?
Well, you can see Travis going high-low, trying to find the grip. It's not necessarily the quickest when you're on the inside line in these conditions. On the outside, you do get that fluffy stuff, but the tires can dig.
Whoa!
He's in the wall. Pastrana in the wall on the landing. Came down on the K-rail on the left-hand side, and he's broken the suspension.
No.
So Pastrana is out. Absolutely sent it. I'm sure we'll get a view from the outside line, but that leaves Kevin Eriksson, who's just recovered from a broken ankle. Remember, this is his debut in the FC1X, and he's going to be in the final battle.
Well, you got to remember, he helped develop this thing, so he's got more seat time than anybody behind the wheel FC1X, as we're now in the cockpit of Pastrana. Just overcooked it, kicked off to the left, so unfortunate turn of events there for Pastrana as we were riding shotgun with him. So Pastrana just getting too sendy. And just overcooks it, gets into the wall. That front left corner collapses like Bambi on ice. And Kevin Eriksson will get the victory. Who's he going to go against? Is it going to be his brother? Is he going against Ollie? Or is he going against Robin Larson, who is our current points leader?
Yeah, looking down at Larson's qualifying record, of course, he was first in the UK, was third in Sweden. So he went out in the semifinals in Sweden. If he makes it through and manages to take it here, Larson will be the first person to take two TQs with the FC1X.
That's right.
I'm kind of in to seeing Oliver Eriksson versus
Kevin
Eriksson.
I'd love to see Kevin Ollie.
Well, you've worked with the family a lot, Fraz. I mean, what will Andreas Eriksson be doing if he's got to deal with both his sons in the same race? Will he be freaking out?
Oh, man, I think Andreas would hand over the headset to one of the other guys.
Do you really?
No, they're an awesome set of brothers. I was, you know, privileged to spend a lot of time with them in Sweden. Very competitive, but you know, the love for one another is you know, as high as it can be. So
yeah, for sure.
I guess we'll see who can win the next battle, and a brother fight would be interesting.
Yeah. It would be good.
All right, there it is. Kevin Eriksson gets the victory as unfortunately Travis Pastrana takes himself out, breaking that front left suspension and causing him to halt. So there he is, getting outside of his vehicle. And there is the number 199, Travis Pastrana, walking off. But Kevin Eriksson comes out the victor. He will move on to the finals. And we will find out who he is going against. They're already on that start grid. And we're talking about Ollie Eriksson and Robin Larson.
How the fortunes changed this morning. Kevin clipped one of those big white truck tires in the background, ripped the front corner off the car. This time it was Pastrana's turn, went just a little bit too big on the jump out of turn one, landed on the K-rail and took his side off. So, yeah, this morning Kevin wasn't down in the dumps, but he was saying, look, I don't even know if they're going to get the car fixed in time for the next session. They had 40 minutes. But the team worked super hard. They got it done. And now he's into that final battle. There is Pastrana.
All right, Travis walking off. It's not the way you want to exit the track, right?
No.
Sorry, hate to pick the scab, but you know, you said there's a chance, man. That'd be absolutely awesome and epic if you fight back for us.
I'm surprised Pastrana there kept that door shut, didn't he? But then on the exit, just a little bit too wide, and Kevin got that inside line. I thought when Kevin was forced inside, he might have to wait longer on the throttle.
Oh, here's what
it worked out. It was tiny, look. That's the jump that caught out Arpin last year. It's the one where Faust nearly landed on the top of Hansen.
Oh, my gosh.
It's huge. And it, Pastrana out.